Good afternoon all. Myself Jidin T. Sundaran, Senior Nursing Officer, AIIMS Bhubaneswar. Today we are discussing about the commonly used drugs in the ICE intensive care units and B&W management in COVID-19 areas. At the end of this section, the participant will be able to know the commonly used drugs in intensive care units and biomedical waste management in COVID-19 areas. Let us start with an introduction. As we know that drugs as a chemical substance used in the treatment, cure, prevention or diagnosis of disease are used to otherwise enhance physical or mental well-being. Most of the emergency cases are life-threatening, so that we need to drug that decrease fatal chance and improving the heart-lung function. Let us see some of the emergency situations we are facing in intensive care units that we are categorized into 7. First one is cardiovascular, second respiratory emergencies, third neurological emergency for poison and overdose, then endocrine emergency, fluid and electrolyte imbalance, others that we can see in next slide. Let us see one by one in details. In cardiovascular emergencies, we are seeing in ICUs, most common cases are cardiovascular arrest, cardiogenic shock, cardiac arrhythmias, pulmonary edema, acute coronary syndrome, and hypertensive emergencies. In respiratory emergencies, we are facing bronchial asthma, acute exacerbation of COPD. In neurological emergency, mostly we are facing seizures and head injuries. The next category is poisons and overdoses. Endocrine emergencies such as diabetic ketoacidosis and hypoglycemia, mostly in early morning in ICU situation, and fluid and electrolyte imbalance. In others, anaphylactic shock, preeclampsia, the antenatal mother admitted with other medical condition can enter preeclampsia in ICU, then septic shock. Now we are discussing about some of the commonly used drugs in ICU that we are categorized into various types. The first one is anesthetics. In anesthetic drugs, we are again classified into local anesthetic, sedative, anticholinergic, opioids, and muscle relaxant. Local anesthetic are the drug that block the sensation of the pain in the region where they are administered. That mainly we are using in small suturing procedure, lumbar puncture, and some type of procedures like central line. Common drugs we are using in ICU are lignocaine plain and lignocaine with adrenaline. Next we are going to sedative. Sedatives commonly prescribed in ICU environment for the treatment of agitation and anxiety, which may cause by different conditions such as dyspnea, delirium, mechanical ventilation, lack of sleep, and untreated pain. The commonly used sedatives in ICUs are midazolam, lorazepam, dexmed, and for the short-acting, we are using injection propofol. Then anticholinergic. Next, opioids. Most commonly used opioids in ICUs are injection morphine and injection finergan. Then we are using muscle relaxants such as vecuronium and succinylcholine during tracheostomy, intubation, and for continuous paralysis of the intubated patient, especially for controlling the aerosol during COVID-19 patient. Next, we are going to the commonly used cardiac drugs in ICU. It again classified into antiarrhythmic, antihypertensive, inotropes, and diuretics. In antiarrhythmic, commonly we are using injection amiodarone and injection adenosine. Next, antihypertensive, commonly we are using in ICUs are nitroglycerin and injection labetalol. Then we are going to inotropes group. Inotropes are classified into mainly two groups, positive inotropes and negative inotropes. The positive inotropes increase the contractibility force of the heart, and the negative inotropes will decrease the contractibility force of the heart. For positive inotropes, examples are injection dopamine, digoxin, dobutamine, adrenaline, and noradrenaline. For the negative inotropes, we are using atenolol, metoprolol, and verapamil. Next category is diuretics. Most commonly we are using injection furosemide and spironolactone in ICU setup. Next we are discussing about respiratory medicine. In respiratory we are mainly using bronchodilators, antiasthmatic, and corticosteroid. Bronchodilators and antiasthmatic, mainly we are using duolin and budecort nebulization. And in corticosteroids, we are using injection dexamethasone and methylprednisolone as a drug of choice in COVID-19 patient. Next category is thrombolytic agents. It dissolves the dangerous clots in the blood vessels and improve blood flow and prevent damage to the tissue and organs. The commonly used thrombolytic agents in ICUs are aspirin, Cloplet, warfarin, LNWH, heparin, and streptokinase. Next category is antidotes. Antidotes we are using for the snake bite, anti-snake venom, and the universal antidotes like charcoal. For the organophosphorus cases, we are using atropine as an antidote. Next category is IV fluids. Are important in an ICU setup. Normally, we are using hypotonic solutions such as 0.45 saline, 0.25 dextrose. Then, hypertonic solutions such as 3% NS and 10% dextrose. Then, isotonic solutions examples are 0.9% saline, DNS. And Ringer lactate solution. And next, plasma volume expanders. Normally we are using in circulatory shock to restore the vascular volume. Mainly we are using dextran as a plasma volume expander in ICU setup. Next we are going to specific nurses' responsibility before administering these drugs. First one is select an appropriate device for administration like syringe pump, infusion pump, then proper dilution, then proper drip sets such as micro drip, macro drips, and next monitor hemodynamic status of the patient. Before giving the medication, we have to check that the vitals and the patient urine output. Then any previous drug intake or any allergies we have to check before administering the medications. Next one is test dose if required. Then proper route such as large bore canalization, central line, and sublingual route. And if any abnormal event happen, stop the infusion and inform the physician. Next we are going to discuss about biomedical waste management in COVID-19 areas. Biomedical waste are the waste generated during diagnosis, treatment, or immunization of human being or animal or research activities. Next, we are going to discuss about waste collection in COVID-19 areas. For that purpose, separated color-coded bins with foot-operated lids or container we are using with a double-layered bag ensure to adequate strength and no leaks. Mainly, we are using different color codes for collecting the waste. Here we are using black bucket, yellow, red and blue box and white box. In black buckets, we are collecting empty juice bottles, water bottles, discarded papers, cotton boxes, wrappers, medicines and syringes, betadine bottle, hand rub bottle, sanitizer bottle, which are not used at COVID patient bedside. Any other item which were not contaminated by patient secretion or body fluid. The wet, we are using fruit peels, vegetable, leftover food not contaminated by the patient secretions. That types of waste we are collecting in black bucket. In yellow bucket, we are collecting medical and surgical masks, N95 mask, head cover, cap, disposable linen, gown, non-plastic or semi-plastic cover, diapers, sanitary napkins, any item soaked with blood or body fluids, cytotoxic drugs and include all item contaminated with cytotoxic drugs, empty or discarded medicine, blood bag and anatomical waste. In yellow bucket we are collecting goggles, face shield, hamster suit, used gloves, plastic bottle, IV sets, syringes without needle, catheter, Euro bag, drains, IV fluids, and plastic wrapped covers used for COVID-19 patients, pre-tested viral transport medium, plastic vials, vacuum container, and pipette tips. These types of waste we are collecting in red buckets. In blue box, we are collecting broken or unbroken glassware, ampoules, vials, and metallic implants. In white box, we are mainly collecting needles, blades, syringe with fixed needles. Now we are discussing about waste treatment in COVID-19 areas. First, separated color-coded foot-operated bins or containers we are using. Double-layered bags using two bags should be used. Mandatory labeling of bags, containers as COVID-19 waste. Dedicated trolleys, electrical vehicles paid for this purpose only. Proper segregation of shard items mainly concerned to prevent needle stick injury. Trolleys and collection bin should be disinfected with 1% sodium hypochlorite solution daily. Reporting of operation of COVID-19 wards, ICU, sample collection center, laboratories to SPCB and respective CBWTF. Dedicated sanitation work with provision of full PPE with 3-layer mask, splash proof, apron, gowns, nitrile gloves, gum boots, and safety goggles. Any worker showing symptoms of illness, age greater than 50 years, refrain from working at the facility. Till now, we are discussing about what are the emergency situation in intensive care units and what are the common drugs we are using and nurses' responsibilities. Along with we are discuss the biomedical waste management and its collection and waste treatment. I hope that everybody understand my topic, and if you have any queries, please text in comment box. Thank you all for the kind